In this screencast, we will take a look at the important parts of a generic first-order transfer function. And in order to explore this, we'll do this in the context of the problem provided, where we see there's a dynamic response of a stirred tank bioreactor can be represented by the transfer function 2 over 4s plus 2, which represents how a change in an input variable, the feed substrate concentration, can influence the exit substrate concentration, here represented as C prime, both of these represented in deviation variables. So in part A of the problem, we are asked to determine the value of the gain and the time constant. Before we do that, let's talk a little bit about what those two variables are. The gain, which is often represented by K, can be defined as how a change in an input variable influences the change in an output variable. Here, it is in its most generic form, which is in partial derivative form. However, many times this can be approximated as just the delta, just the change in the output variable divided by the change in the input variable. So, for example, if a gain is 6, what that would represent is the fact that if I change my input variable by 1 unit, that will cause at steady state, once the process reaches that steady state, a change in 6 units of the output variable. The time constant, which is represented by tau, is a representation of how quickly the process will reach its steady state. So the quicker the process reaches steady state, that is indicated by a lower value of tau. So important part here is as tau goes down, system reaches its steady state faster. So to do this, what we're going to have to do is just factor out the 2 that's in the constant. So what's going to happen here is 2 over 4s plus 2 is going to become 2 divided by, if we factor out the 2, 2s plus 1. And this will equal 1 over 2s plus 1. And now that we are in standard form, we can clearly see the fact that the value of our gain, our steady state gain, is 1. And the value of our time constant, tau, is 2. If you are developing your own first-order transfer function from material or an energy balance, a good check to make sure that what you've done is correct would be to note the fact that your time constant would have to have units of time. However, the units of the gain are drastically different depending on the transfer function you're analyzing, which leads us into part B, where part B is asking for what are the units of the gain. And in order to look at the units of the gain, just recall the definition, or units, here was the output variable was the exit concentration C prime. The input variable was the feed concentration CF prime. Both of these are going to have units, the numerator and the denominator, of moles per liter, or a concentration unit. So when all is said and done, the gain will have no dimensions in this case. Please note the fact that not all gains are unitless. In fact, most gains are not. It just depends on what the variables of the output variable that you're analyzing and the input variable that you're analyzing are. Part C is asking if the feed concentration instantaneously goes up by 2 moles per liter and the current concentration is 2 moles per liter, then the question's asking, what will the new concentration be? In order to do that, we can again take advantage of the definition of the gain. So the gain, as noted right above, is the change in the output variable. So that will be C nu minus the current concentration divided by the same for the feed concentration. We know the fact that the gain for this process as found above is equal to 1. And we know from the problem statement the fact that the CF has been increased instantaneously by 2 moles per liter, so that will be 2 in the denominator. We know that the current concentration of the outlet concentration is 2 moles per liter, so we're solving for C nu. After doing some algebra, what we can see is the fact that C nu will be 4 moles per liter. The fourth and final part of the question asks, how long does it take to reach steady state? How long the process will take to reach steady state is dependent on not only the transfer function, but also the forcing function, or in other words, how the input has changed in what fashion. The process would obviously take longer to reach steady state as if this change of 2 moles per liter in the inlet feed concentration happened over 2 hours versus if it happened over 5 minutes. So in this case, the input variable is instantaneously increasing, so an instantaneous change can just be noted as a step function. And a step function is a very common transfer function we use to analyze controlled systems or process systems. So for a first order process, we have a relationship already developed by using Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transforms to develop a function of how the output variable y will be affected by a step change in an input variable x. So it can be defined as the relationship y prime equals k, the steady state gain, multiplied by m, and this represents the magnitude of the step, multiplied by 1 minus e to the negative t, which is just the generic time variable, over tau, the time constant. So if we look at this in a little bit more detail, we can get some mathematical insights into what is going on. If we look at the second term in the parentheses, we have this exponential term e raised to the negative t over tau. We can envision that as t gets very high, this exponential will approach negative infinity, or in other words, it will approach zero. So if we have this variable t over tau, we can gain some insight as to how large this value will be. As t goes to tau, what happens is that exponential becomes e to the negative first, which is about 0.368. So therefore, what that means is the fact that y prime will equal km times 0.632. But as time approaches 5 tau, what happens is this now becomes the exponential of negative 5, and that is approximately 0. So what that tells us is the fact that by this time, e to the negative t over tau, the term which can potentially vary, will really no longer vary. Will it do it to some minimal degree? Yes, but for all intents and purposes, this system has now approached Km, and it's going to stay that way for the rest of the time. So therefore, as an estimate, we can estimate steady state will occur after 5 tau. And recall the fact that 5 tau, that tau was 2, so therefore this will happen after 10. I'm going to put here time units because we never defined what units the tau was in. It'll be 10 minutes, hours, or seconds. So here with this example, we hope that you get a better understanding of the gain and the time constant and what those values represent.